Media training definition. What is the definition of media training? Traditionally, it's about when you work with an executive or a group of people and you train them specifically on how to be interviewed by the news media, specifically if television is involved and a video camera. So that is the most common notion of media training. Now, there's a broader definition, which means anytime you're using media like a video camera to train someone. So among the broader population, they'll use the term media training to describe what people like me call public speaking training and presentation skills training. The way we divide it within the industry is media training, meaning you're talking to a reporter, an anchor, a host. There's some intermediary between you and the final audience. That's the traditional notion of media training. And presentation training, meaning you're talking to people and they're right there. They're in the room. There's no reporter editing things down, taking quotes, taking sound bites, and putting it into a bigger story. So it's a different type of communication. The way I look at it is media training is a subsection of presentation training, which is a subsection of communication skills training. So that's how I define media training. Typically, what happens in media training is individuals are taught four very specific skills. The first is knowing how to look comfortable, confident, relaxed, anytime you're in front of a video camera or a microphone. For most people, that's the toughest type of media interview because you feel scared, you feel insecure. You think, what do I do with my hands? Where do I look? Do I need makeup? All these things go through people's minds and it's nerve-wracking. So good media training will show you how to come across your very best, and you get to the point where you're not nervous anymore, because if you know you look and sound your best, there's no rational reason anymore to be nervous. If you don't know how you look, if you're afraid that you look scared, stiff, nervous, uncomfortable, and you're actually looking scared, stiff, and uncomfortable, well, then it's rational to be fearful and nervous of the media and the media opportunity. So that's the first big thing that goes on in media training, is helping people look comfortable, confident, and relaxed. The second big skill set that goes on in most media trainings is helping people shape a media message. It's not just you answering questions. It's about you telling the reporter and the audience of that reporter, the viewers, the listeners, the readers in that media outlet, what's most important. You, as the person being interviewed, get to have a say on what you think is most important on that topic. So that's the second big skill that goes on in traditional media training, is helping people figure out what to say. The problem most people have is they want to say too much. They want to share their knowledge. They want to share their insights. They want to educate the reporter and tell them 50, 100 different messages on every question. The problem with that is you feel good at the time. You feel like you're being interesting. You feel like you're being a great professor in college. But when you look at the story the next day, in a paper, online, on broadcast, radio or TV, you end up either with no quote or a quote that is almost irrelevant to the points you felt were most important. You lose all control if you just toss out as many messages as possible. So much of media training is about giving people the skills to come up with a good, clear, focused, three-part message that's genuinely interesting to the reporter, important to you, the spokesperson for your organization, and also interesting to the readers, viewers, listeners of that media outlet. That's the second skill. The third skill that's covered in most media training is, how do you answer questions from reporters? It's not like a normal conversation. And yet it's not what people think. People have the mistaken notion that media training is all about ignore the questions and just say whatever you want. Yeah, there are a few people who can get away with that, but the vast, vast majority of public servants, authors, experts, CEOs who try that are going to be punished by the media and the audiences of the media. So no, you cannot simply ignore the questions. There is an art and a skill to answering questions in media interviews. It's something that can be taught, it's something that can be learned, but it is a process. There was a process that you followed to learn how to write in whatever language is your first language. No one's born a natural-born writer. It's a skill you're taught. Well, there's also a skill in answering questions in media interviews. So that's the third really big component of media training. The fourth component, the final and really the most important, is packaging your messages with interesting, quotable sound bites. Because you can have a great message, you can smile, you can be nice and friendly, and never get quoted in a story or never get the quotes you want if you don't plan and prepare the exact quotes you want for that story. So that's what goes on in media training. Now, media training in broader culture is often tossed around when we see someone sweating or looking nervous or doing a horrible job at a media interview. Oh, that person needs media training. Or someone doing a horrible job at a job interview to say, well, they need media training too. That's a type of presentation training, and the best way of doing it is using the medium of a video camera and video technology. So it is a type of media training, helping people prepare for job interview questions. But it's not the most commonly used term for that phrase, media training. Now, something that has happened in the last decade or so is there's another branch of media training that is just for social media. And that can include everything from how frequently you should post on Instagram, how often should you repeat your tweets on Twitter. It also includes specifically how to present yourself in video for various social media outlets. If you are a millennial and you're trying to do humor or pop culture news and you're doing a YouTube channel, you may need to not only look comfortable and confident, but have edits every 2 seconds to have a certain style that your audience will enjoy. The biggest problem most people have of any age whatsoever is that when they are thinking about communicating through social media using video, they stop. They just don't do it. They never get over the initial hump. They tell themselves, I'm not good enough, I'm not articulate enough, I'm not good looking enough, my hair isn't good enough, my eyes are too beady, I have a double chin. Everyone has some insecurities. Everyone has something. They don't like their voice. They think their hands are too big or something. You know, after training tens of thousands of people from 7 continents for the last 35 years, I can tell you, I've seen every possible excuse people have for not wanting to put their camera on or their face on camera. Everyone thinks they're different. Everyone thinks they're special, and yes, everybody's special. But everybody's exactly the same from my perspective in that their excuse for why they can't go on video, why they can't make a YouTube video or a Facebook Live video or a Twitter video or a LinkedIn video, their excuse is illegitimate. Their excuse is just that, it's an excuse. There's no valid reason. The hard part is you just have to start doing it. Nobody goes to first grade knowing how to write perfect English typically, or kindergarten knowing how to write perfect English. Someone was taught. You're taught, here's how you make the letter A if you're learning in English. And yet, we live in a world where how well you write might not have that big of an impact on your career, but how well you speak to the media, to investors, to customers, clients, vendors, employees, how well you speak can have a huge, huge impact on the career of perhaps the majority of workers in the world. And yet, no one is ever taught how to speak, how to give presentations, job interviews, or certainly how to speak to the news media. and certainly not how to speak on YouTube or Facebook. And yet these are skills that are essential in the modern economy, especially for people who are ambitious and want to get to the top of their field, whatever that field is. That's why it's critically important that you figure out a media training system that works for you. There are online courses. I make tons and tons of online courses. You can check them out at mediatrainingworldwide.com. You can watch YouTube videos on how to prepare yourself better for media interviews. There are live workshops. There are one-on-one trainings. I travel the globe working with people just like you, conducting media training seminars, workshops, boot camps, whatever you want to call it. It's all about building your skills in these four levels. So that's the basic definition of media training. I hope that's cleared it up for you. Good luck with all of your media interviews and presentations in life.